Hey, how people act when they get a statue? Like they just got through looking at some Dracula movie. They were astonished, why? That God had delivered that man. All right, we're going to stop right there. This is good, but what am I saying? Passover is time for your deliverance. All right, we're going to go and talk here a little bit about Passover and Feast of Unleavened Bread. Passover is celebrated annually for approximately 3,500 years. It commemorates the Israelites' deliverance from bondage, a story of redemption and deliverance through the blood of an unblemished lamb. Unblemished lamb. Y'all know the story that God told the people of Israel when they were in Egypt before they got deliverance was they had to take a lamb or a goat, one of them, and raise him and keep him clean. Feed him a certain way and keep him clean. And then when it was time for their Passover, then you were supposed to sacrifice that lamb. And when you kill the lamb, then you would take his blood and sprinkle it over your doorposts. And when the death angel went by your house, someone sung a song, it said that he will pass over you, your house. Those people that didn't have the blood applied to the house, to their lives, then they lost their firstborn son or whatever, they dropped dead. But remember, God gave the instruction. He told them what to do. God is giving instruction now to not only to the church, but he's giving it to America, to the American people, if they got time to listen. It's to stop all this other foolishness that we're doing and get down to the real festival. I'm not against having a festival, but this is the main one. This was the festival that would keep us out of hell. And this was the festival, the feast day, that would give us eternal life in Jesus. This was the greatest festival because it paid the price for what? Our sins. John said, behold, the Lamb of God that take away the what? Sins of the world. Someone sung a song that said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. The question is, do you have the blood applied to your life? That when the death angel comes, will he pass over you? Oh my God. Go to 1 Corinthians 5 and 7. Our Passover has since been realized in Yeshua. Messiah has become our Passover. Christ the Anointed. Jesus in Hebrew is Yeshua. Yeshua, meaning Savior, meaning Deliverer. God promised that he would deliver his people in the Old Testament, and Jesus just fulfilled that he's that same God that will save his people, what? From their sins. Not only save his people from their sins, but he will save the whole world from their sins if they only, what? Believe and trust in him. 1 Corinthians 5, 7, what did it say? That you may be a new lump as you are unleavened. Now we're going through not only Passover, but we're also in unleavened bread. Unleavened bread was bread without yeast in it, because yeast is symbolizes as sin. And we all yet have sin in our lives. Why? Because we're still in these mortal bodies. My flesh gets up and it wants to do evil. Well, I know y'all not like that, but I'm just being honest about how I am. Well, I know if I'm like this, I know you are too. Just don't be a hypocrite. Huh? I forgot how to smoke weed. Huh? I ain't forgot how to do a lot of things, just like you. But my spirit, man, that part that's been born again, is saying, no, you need to get in the Word and And you need to get in some studies. You need to get in prayer. That's the part that's been born again. But the part that hasn't been born again, it yet want to do. See, God don't save your flesh. He saved your spirit. Because your flesh, even after you say it, still want to keep doing the same thing. All right. All right. Come on. Did you finish that? 5 and 7. 1 Kings 5 and 7. Right. That's the end of that. Christ is our Passover. So when we say Passover, we're celebrating Christ. Did it say anything about Easter? Where's Easter at? Where's your eggs and bunny rabbit at and your chocolate covered egg? Where's it at? We'll talk about Passover and that death angel. Now we talk about unleavened bread. The Jews, would, if they had anything with yeast in their house, they would get it out. For 7 days. They would inspect it too, to make sure. Unleavened bread to us is getting sin out of our lives. What I mean by that? Quit doing a lot of evil stuff. Y'all are still doing evil stuff, then this is the time that you can get victory over that. If you're a Christian and still looking at pornography, this is your time to get delivered. If you're a Christian and still hating on folk and doing a lot of adultery stuff, this is time for your deliverance. Don't tell me what people won't do now. Huh? He's in church. Yeah, I know. I know about church folk. I've been around for a while. I've seen a whole lot of stuff. Didn't one of your stars, they catch him cursing? His son put out that he was cursing? Well, he needs to repent. Like everybody else, he needs to repent. Not only to the people, but he needs to repent to God. Why? Because he's a person that people look up to. You'd be surprised what folks say, what goes through folks' mind. Hey, I don't want to be a recorder and record what's going through your mind. I don't want that because I'm from... I said, I thought he was saved. I thought she was a Christian. Come on here. The Feast of Unleavened Bread begins the day after Passover and lasts for 7 days. Throughout the week, Jewish families removed all leaven from their homes and ate only unleavened bread. No sweets, no cakes, no pies, nothing with leaven in it for 7 days. Can you discipline yourself for 7 days? Well, you ought to, but there's plenty of other things you can eat. But you know how we are. I don't like that. Well, you and I have a problem. You're going to be made to like it. Get rid of all the leaven out of your house. Don't eat things that got leaven in it. And the things that I know that's making me weak, then I'm going to lay it aside. The Bible says, lay aside every weight and the sin that's so easily backset us. He's not talking to sinner people. He's talking to people in the church that are saved. You know what you got to lay aside. I ain't got to get up here and prophesy to you. Yes, my brother, I see. No, you know what's going on. I ain't seeing nothing and don't want to see. Now let the Holy Ghost say something. Then if it is, I'll go to you personally. Okay. In preparing for their deliverance from Egypt. How long were they enslaved in Egypt? How many years? Wasn't it 430 years? Somewhere along in there. It's about time for black folk to get delivered from America. It's been over 400 years. It's time for our deliverance. Time is at hand for the enslavement of black people in America. Not only black people, but Indian folk too. Black and people of color here in America, it's time for our deliverance. And our deliverance is where? In Yeshua. See why the devil will keep you out of the feast days? Why? Because he knows there's power in there. There's power in keeping these days. And these days are not legalistic. If you don't do it, they don't do it. No. This is all an individual thing. People have made denominations out of this. No, that ain't the way God said it. You just obey God when you hear truth and you keep the feast days. In preparing for their deliverance from Egypt, God instructed the children of Israel, when you hear my voice, leave in haste and do not wait for the bread to rise. You better get out of there in a hurry. Get out of Egypt in a hurry. Because I'm dealing with Pharaoh, and Pharaoh going to let y'all go. Now, if y'all stayed any longer, he might change again. But get out. That's found in the book of Deuteronomy 16. I don't have time to go there. Immediate action was required. Jesus is the fulfillment of the Feast of Unleavened Bread. He is the ultimate obedient one, whose instant and perfect obedience, Jesus was obedient to the death of the cross. God had to have a man that didn't have sin in him. He couldn't have me because I got sin in my life. I couldn't be a sacrifice. But God had to prepare him a body. And God had to become a man. I was listening to one guy. He talking about he can't believe that. You believe everything else, you need to believe this here. But I can't believe God become a man. Well, that's what the Bible teaches. God loved us so much that he took upon himself to become a man and to what? Die for wicked sinners, no good people, to keep us out of the pits of hell and destruction. See, when you don't accept Christ, your life will self-destruct. A lot of us here this morning, we're here because we got saved, but other than that, we were going to self-destruct. You just stay on the wages of sin is what? Death. But the gift of God is what? Eternal life in Christ Jesus. We're on our way to a death. God's people got them out there. God got his people out there. And there was nothing but in front of them was a Red Sea. And in the back and side of them was what? Pharaoh's on the side of them was what? A wilderness. They have no choice now. Moses was delirious. Said, you done got these people out of Egypt. Now all of them gonna die. You know, God ain't like it. You see God panicking, having an anxiety attack, about to pass out. Ooh, I'm glad God ain't like us. He see what's ahead and he pass out. Oh, God. He pass out like some of us do. And God just say, Moses, what's that you got in your hand? I know Moses. Well, this turned into a snake, but look what I'm faced with now. We got to think on God, on the past victories that we had in the past, and that will propel us to believe God for the next victory. Didn't God do it one time, two times, three times? Now he'll do it again. Moses, stretch out your rod, bud, man. Moses wanted to get on his knees and pray. It's too late for prayer. You should have been praying 40 years ago, man. You should have been praying a long time ago. Now you right in the midst of what? Hell! Moses, just stretch out your rod. And as Moses stretched out his rod, then the power of God began to work. Come on here. God began to work now. God caused the east wind to blow all night long. The waters part. In a bunch of mud, they walked on. They went through the sea. God provided. God wants us to go through our trials and tests. And I know our trials and tests, man, they get big, they get heavy. Oh my God. The trials and tests got so heavy with Jesus and his disciples went to sleep. And the Bible said that sweat came out like great drops of blood. Ooh, that's some sweat in there. Whew. Why? Because he had the weight of the world upon him. God had laid the sin of the world upon who? Jesus. All that God has done for people, you should never reject him. But people still do. And God is yet patient with us. He's yet long-suffering with us. It's not his will that nobody perish. But they are perishing by the thousands. They're leaving here by the thousands without Christ. It ain't God's fault. And I pray to God it ain't my fault. I hope I had a chance to witness, and I did. Because if not, God gonna hold their blood on your hand. Oh my God. Oh, that's a whole different message there. At Passover, he took the unleavened bread and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Every time we do the Lord's Supper, we're partaking of the Passover. We stopped, and people don't explain it. The Lord's Supper is Passover. It was the Lord. And if you go to the book of Luke 22:19, go to Luke 22:19. And I got 5 minutes, y'all, and I'm going to try to wrap this up. Luke 22:19. Jesus told his disciples to go, and it's going to be a man there. You go in that man's house, he's going to have a water basin, and he's going to have a room prepared for us. And I'll partake of the Last Supper. Kind of remind me that me and my wife seen my mother, Mother Owens, when she transitioned, but we didn't know she was going to transition. And the Lord told me to take the wine and the bread over there. And we had the Lord's Supper, you know. And the next couple of weeks, then she made a transition. But we had a chance to do the Lord. See, God knows what he's doing. I don't know. I mean, I don't know what's going on. But just obey God. If God tell you to do something and you believe it's God, because God ain't going to tell you to do nothing ungodly, he's going to have you do the right thing. And because it is God, the devil going to talk about you. But that was her Last Supper. Oh, praise God. She had the Last Supper. Okay, okay, okay. What did it say? 22:19. Read on real quick.
Uh-huh.
And gave thanks.
And
break it.
And gave it unto them thanks.
Mm-hmm.
This is my body which is given to you.
Oh my God, this is my body which is given to you.
This do in remembrance of me.
Is that it?
Likewise also took the cup.
The cup?
After supper saying,
mm-hmm.
This cup is the New Testament in my blood.
In my what?
In my blood.
In my blood. Blood, blood. Blood is the life. Blood is what a life is. So God did what? Gave his blood. Why? Because there's life in the blood. Read on, yo.
Which is shed for you.
Which is shed for you and I. This is, sometimes you read the gospels, sound like it's too good to be true, but it is true. Oh, I praise God. I thank him. Come on, read on. We almost through. Every time you go to a table, every time you go to an important meeting for something that you want to do for somebody, something special, the civil rights or whatever it is, there's always a betrayer at the table. There's always a Judas there that'll report back. But that's okay. God got that under control. Read on.
And truly the Son of Man goeth as it was determined.
But woe unto that man to whom he was betrayed. Oh, my God. Is that all of that? Okay. Now we'll move on real quick. Give me a few more minutes, y'all. Y'all can bear with me. Can y'all bear with me? First Fruits begins at sunset on Saturday, April 3rd, and ends at nightfall Sunday, April 4th. I'm a firm believer that Jesus' death, the crucifixion, started, and he was put in the grave on a Wednesday. Now, this is me. Now, everybody's got it different. I'm going with Wednesday night. That's one, ain't it? Yeah. So it, from Wednesday night to the next, to the Thursday? Uh-huh. First day. Okay. So would Wednesday be, at Wednesday 3 o'clock, didn't they put him in the grave? Somewhere along in there? Well, was he in there at sundown on Wednesday? So we'd go back to Thursday. That'd be one day. One day, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So he had to get up Saturday, is that right? After the Sabbath? So that'll put him at 3 days and 3 nights. Well, he was already up then.
Yeah.
We'll get it straight. It takes time. All right, all right. During first fruits in ancient Israel, the Israelites would take the first fruit of their spring harvest and offer it to God, demonstrating their thankfulness to their provider, and thus sanctifying their whole harvest. Leviticus 23:9-14. Consider this. In the spring, the earth looks dead, don't it? Come on, y'all. During the winter months, it looks like ain't nothing gonna happen. It's brown, it looks crazy out there, it's dead. The trees are not blooming, it just looks dead. But that's when God gets ready to operate. When they crucified Jesus, it was over with what most of them thought. But it wasn't over with, it was just the beginning of a new life. Huh? Somebody said they crucified God. No, they didn't, because God can't never die. His physical body died, but God in Jesus kept right on living. Hey, that's just like you. You don't die. After you die and they bury you and throw dirt in your face, your spirit keep right on living. Your body's dead. Oh, my God. Y'all catch it later. Consider this. In the spring, the earth that looked dead during the winter suddenly becomes life. For example, color flowers and a variety of fruits miraculously appear out of the gray and brown, lifeless earth. It is like the dead earth suddenly comes to life. During Passover, those things that are dead and alive, God wants to bring it to life. Those circumstances, those conditions, those things that we're going through, God wants to speak life to us. Anxiety will get easier. Panic attacks will go away. Come on here. Being depressed will leave. Worry and doubt will leave us. And we'll get victory over it in Jesus' name. How can you enjoy life and you're always depressed? My former pastor said, every time I talk to that one of my members, they got a hard luck story. Now see what he's talking about, a hard luck story. God gonna change the hard luck. And if I can say good luck, well, I put it this way, good blessings. It's going to come your way. In the same way, 2,000 years ago, Jesus was dead. He had to die. He had to taste death for you and I. Let us know it ain't that bad. But supernaturally came back to life on the Feast of First Fruits and then ascended to the Father as first fruits of those raised from the dead. Even after he got up from the dead, other folks got up too. Somebody said, oh, that ain't enough. The Bible said it's over 500 people that seen him. I can imagine that the disciples, when they seen him, the Bible said they went and grabbed his hand and held on to him. I would have done the same thing. Jesus, you have been raised from the dead. Lord, have mercy. Help me to believe. Let me touch it first. A lot of y'all like Doubt Thomas. Well, at least Doubt Thomas was honest. You know, it was so much fear going on in that camp, man, to nobody, even Peter them didn't believe it. Until Jesus came and talked to him, and then he left. They said, hey, man, wait a minute. He had to open up their eyes. Wait a minute, he quoted the scripture, man. That was Jesus. Doubt Thomas said, except I put my hand in his side and put my hand in his hand. Amen. I ain't believing nothing. Look, Jesus being God heard him way across town. Said, let me go show old Doubt and Thomas something. And when I come in, I'm going to walk through the door. Oh, my God, have mercy. And he got right in front of Doubt and Thomas and said, Thomas, put your head in my side. Doubt says, oh, my Lord and my God, I believe now. But you know what the Lord said? Blessed are those that haven't seen and yet believe. Our faith is even more potent now. I'm almost through here. Come on here. Go to 1 Corinthians 15:20. 1 Corinthians 15:20. Somebody must took my time up this morning. I'm going to blame y'all. But it's all good. 1 Corinthians 15:20. In ancient Israel, God accepted the whole harvest through the first fruit offering. So it is today. We are accepted and loved by the Father God through the first fruit offering of Mashiach. I'm going to stop. stop right there. Read that 1 Corinthians 15:20. What does it say? What? If God hadn't got up from the grave, we'd be the most miserable people. Well, if he ain't got up from the grave, I can celebrate Easter. I can celebrate Easter eggs, chocolate eggs, and stuff, because he's still in the grave. But because he got up, what, out of the grave, and he's alive forevermore, he said, I'm he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I'm what? I'm alive for what? Evermore. And I got the keys to death and hell. Oh, you can shout now. Hallelujah. And because I live, you gonna live. Is that all of that? That resurrection is. The resurrection is powerful. It's one thing they can't take away, even though they call it Easter. They call it resurrection. We changed it from Easter to resurrection, didn't we? We still won't get Passover, but we're going to get it. It's Passover. You know, with all these plagues going out and these sicknesses, there's more to come after the coronavirus. COVID-19 is lightweight. You wait till they start having earthquakes. And all these other things that Yeshua said was going to take place just prior to his return. The saints of God, those that love God, they're going to get closer to God. And those that hate God, they're going to get further and further away from him. Church people are not going to be able to stand in this time. You got to be more than a church person. You got to be all in or you all out. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for an opportunity to minister to these great people. I trust that your word went out. And your word will not return void. God, as we celebrate Passover, unleavened bread, first fruits, and Pentecost, we thank you that as we celebrate these days, that you promised that you would provide and protect us. Touch the unsaved. Touch those that are in hospitals, those that are troubled in their mind, and those that are disturbed. Give them deliverance right now in Jesus' name.